Hello, I'm Charles Fisher of FishDuck.com. It's time for this week's video fish report about the last game. Now, I don't rehash the whole game as I let the rest of the media do that, but I focus upon a couple of interesting plays. It's tough after a loss, but let's look at some strategy and a couple of positive plays that did take place. Why are the national pundits and sportscasters so myopic? We're hearing their SEC version of events again to explain the obvious to the rest of us, just as it happened last January. We heard on Saturday how the defensive line of Oregon is smallish, yet if you total up both teams on the field in Dallas, you'll find that Oregon's defensive line was a total of 15 pounds heavier than the Tigers. We also heard how we were dominated in the running game, yet the average yardage per rushing attempt was 3.4 yards for Oregon and 3.6 yards for LSU. That is domination. Our running yardage was poor, true, but our total yardage was higher than LSU, 335 to 273, because good Pac-12 teams adjust to their opponents. If you focus on stopping the running game, then we turn to the passing game to move the ball, a total of 240 versus 98 in the passing game. This was a game for Oregon's to win, but the repeated mistakes of penalties, fumbles, and poor judgment by our ball handlers cost us the win. Yes, we had some bad luck in having both our star running backs go down and having to turn to a true freshman. But the fact is, when you carry the ball that way, that loosely, any good team will strip it. Stanford and USC would have done the same thing. The Tigers got 31 of 40 points from 5 drives with an average field position of the Oregon 28-yard line. That's not SEC football. That's gimme football. You could lose to a Sacramento State doing that. Now I know, that's just crazy talk. To be a great team, you need balance to turn to whichever area is available, and the unspoken fact is how the expertise in the Oregon passing game has declined in the past 3 seasons. Our wide receiver core is a work in progress, a far cry from what I saw in Waco the other night from 2 other spread teams in TCU and Baylor. A common denominator the last 4 losses to these out-of-conference teams such as LSU, Auburn, Ohio State, and Boise State has been poor quarterback play in each game. We have a great tradition of passing expertise at Oregon, and we need to return to it to provide the balance needed for the big games. In all 4 games, it was the offense that let the team down and not the defense being unable to hold up. We will get better, and let's look at some samples at how it is happening. In the first quarter, we ran a play that I call an inside option, where we have a speed double option, but the pitch man is to the inside of the quarterback and can get a shovel pass or pitch. We start in a tight outside zone read formation. The early part of the play draws a defender to the quarterback who pitches immediately inside to the running back. Note the great blocking getting set downfield. LaMichael is off and running for a big gain. Later in the game, we begin the same play, only starting out of the inside zone read formation. The defense really commits inside to the running back, thus a huge lane is open for the quarterback to keep and run. While it's difficult to see, we have a bubble pass option at the bottom of the field, which keeps the corner from coming up quickly. Thus, we have a big lane for Darren to run, with superb blocking set up to enable him to get the first down. We had a number of pass plays out of a new formation that I'll call the shotgun T formation. A variety of choices are available between keeping players in to block or sending them out on pass patterns. We ran the ball once from it for a little game, and I can attest to a whole play series being possible from it since I noted other teams operating from this formation. Early in the game, we are threatening to score by lining up in an inside zone read formation going to the right side. LSU is aware of where we're attacking and is preparing to plug that gap. At the snap, we see our offensive linemen begin to come out of their stance, and we see Carson York leaning backwards, beginning his pull to the left for a power play. This is an exciting screenshot as it conveys classic smash mouth football from our power play. You see how Carson has kicked out the linebacker to the left, and David Paulson has completed a monster block to the inside that has stopped the defensive end and a linebacker. He got a twofer. It's another example of how important a great blocking tight end is for our offense. DeAnthony Thomas is lined up in an outside zone read formation going to the left, and we see Clanton pull from his left guard spot to lead DeAnthony into a power play. It's very evident that it's not a zone read, as Darren Thomas is turned to look only at the running back to make the handoff and not a defender at the line of scrimmage. Are we running the power play out of the outside zone read formation now? I don't think so. I believe a true freshman running back simply messed up in where to line up. I am quite confident that this team will clean up the mistakes and play much better through the season. Now let's go win a Rose Bowl.
Oregon fans, I have a huge announcement for you. How many times have you watched an Oregon football highlight video and later you couldn't find it or find the email that had the link in it? We have solved that by creating a massive video archive of Oregon football highlight videos. It's broken down by year and goes all the way back even to the 1958 Rose Bowl. We have documentaries, we have interviews, and we have the motivational ones that get us all pumped up. Yes, the fish duck videos will be there, but more importantly, the huge collection that Mike Wines has of highlight videos, as well as the master, the video historian of Oregon football, Kurt Lidke's massive collection will be there as well. This video archive will be called The Fish Tank, and for good reason, it's a big one. And it's going to contain, are you sitting down, 2,800 highlight videos. Wow. No other site has this, and for good reason. It took an enormous effort by Kurt Lidke and Mike Tunkel to put this together for all of us so that we can sit down and veg out watching our glorious Oregon Ducks. No matter what, win or lose, we love our beloved Ducks. I'm Charles Fisher, Fish Duck, and for more videos and reports, come to fishduck.com.